Hey guys, welcome back to Think Making. I'm Anton, and today I'll be reviewing some PLA filament by Hatchbox. So, let's get to it. Okay, you've probably asked yourself which brand of PLA filament to use. Those that boast superior printing quality are quite expensive. And those cheap ones that come from China, well, we're afraid of jamming our printers with them. Hatchbox is an exception though. They are a Chinese-based company that has been making filaments and gaining popularity for a while. And even if their filaments are on the cheaper end of the spectrum, they don't sacrifice quality and consistency. So let's check them out. Hatchbox filaments always come in this nice box. In the front, you'll see the material type and diameter, while the back has some general information about the filament and their history. In the sides, you'll find their slogan and their website, as well as a sticker indicating the material type, color, printing temperature, and diameter. Inside the box, you'll be greeted with a product catalog. Each product has a code, which you can scan with your smartphone using the Amazon app, and it will direct you to the exact page of that product. Now, isn't that an easy way to buy more stuff? The filament itself is nicely stored in a vacuum-sealed bag with some silica gel inside. It's not resealable though, so get those Ziplocs ready. The spool is basic, but gets most of the points right. It has a huge sticker with some info about the filament, as well as four spots to hold the end. Yet, it's not transparent, so it's hard to know how low on filament you are. The winding of this filament was not the best I've seen, yet it never became a problem. The filament itself is very smooth and shiny. It's also much harder to break than standard PLA. The diameter is also very consistent for a filament that is this cheap. But how well does it print? Well, as always, I printed my three usual test designs, a calibration cube, a Marvin, and a 3D Benchy. Using an E3D V6 at a 0.2 layer height, I found 190 degrees to be a great printing temperature, and hairspray on glass, with or without a heater bed, great for adhesion. However, this may vary for you. And the results, well, they were amazing. The calibration cube looks perfect, all the letters are well defined, and the sides feel very smooth. As for the Marvin, brim was easily removed, and it's actually one of the best Marvins I've printed with a filament that's purely PLA. The same goes to the 3D Benchy. It looks amazing. Curves are pretty smooth, corners are sharp, and overhangs were not a problem. Knowing basically anything would turn out looking good with this filament, I printed Area the Dragon and this cool wireframe shape. Area the Dragon printed very nicely with no errors. Plus, it looks very cool in this copper color. The strange shape I printed was only to see how well bridging did, and I would call it a success. Now check out these other things I've printed with Hatchbox PLA. Some of them have their own videos, so feel free to check them out. So, should you buy this filament? Well, I think it's more like, why wouldn't you buy this filament? I print quite a lot, and around 60% of the filament I use is Hatchbox PLA. I mean, it has all you're looking for: consistent quality and diameter, rich colors, great printing qualities, and a cheap price. So if you want to buy a roll for yourself, I'll leave an Amazon link down in the description along with all the designs I featured in this video. Also remember to tag ThinkMaking in Instagram or Twitter to get a chance to get your creations featured. If you enjoyed this video, go ahead and smash that like button and consider supporting me through Patreon or by buying a cool t-shirt like this one in my merch store. If you don't want to miss any of my videos, don't forget to subscribe. And if you're wondering what to watch next, check out that video. As always guys, thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.